Okay, sure, you want to lose fat, but as I always say and will continue to say, 7-day meal plans, 7-week programs, these short-term solutions are not what's going to give you the results you need and want in the long term, and it's just going to bring you back to square one eventually. So in this video, I want to make sure that you have a full bulletproof plan based around fundamentals that will work for anyone and everyone in the long term when it comes to your fat loss, building your confidence, and increasing your energy levels. Let's get started. What's good, YouTube? It is Coach John back again with another video. This one is about fat loss. I drop fat loss videos, muscle gain videos, and different vlogs and other things that help you build confidence, energy, lose fat, and get the physique and lifestyle of your dreams. If you're interested in doing any of those things, make sure you hit the subscribe button, notification bell, and the like button while you're at it. So I do want to mention that spots for my one-on-one personal coaching program has opened up. If you're interested in working one-on-one with me, you can click below beside the apply now and you can fill out your form. We'll jump on a call, see if we'd be a good fit to work together to help you get to your goals this year. So instead of giving you an exact meal plan and workout to follow and telling you what to do, when to do it, and basically not teaching you anything as to how to do this on your own, and by the way, you do have to figure that out at some point, so why not now? I'm basically going to give you a layout of all the fundamental things you need to do to make sure that you see predictable results. And then within those fundamentals, you will have the flexibility to adjust according to your preference, schedule, according to your needs, wants, goals, etc. So we're going to be covering diet, sleep, water intake, workouts, and cardio. Those five components, the fundamentals to them, what you need to do in each to see results. Let's go. First and foremost, we're going to talk about diet. Diet is, when it comes to fat loss, 10 times more important than working out. Okay, diet is like 99%, not 80%. Workout's like 1%. Still very important though, don't get me wrong, but when it comes to diet, diet is 10 times more important for your fat loss. And people usually focus on diet last. We're gonna get this one done first because a lot of people think it's boring also because they just wanna get to the workouts and take the easy route. But let's talk about diet. So here's what you're gonna do for your diet, okay? You're gonna start by tracking your food every day for the next 7 days as accurately and as consistently as possible. You'll use MyFitnessPal and you'll have to get a kitchen scale if you don't have one. Next thing you're gonna do, you're gonna track your body weight at the same time every morning for 7 days. At the end of these 7 days, you're gonna know exactly how many calories you're at on average for a day-to-day basis and what weight that is keeping you at. Also, you're gonna make sure that of those calories, you're now gonna switch over your protein, if need be, to make sure that you're getting roughly 1 gram per pound of body weight. If it's a little bit less or a little bit more, that's okay, but just have it within that ballpark. From here, now that you know your average calorie intake and what body weight you're currently at, you're gonna cut those calories down anywhere from 1 to 500 calories. So let's say you find that you're an average of 2,000 calories, you're gonna cut it down anywhere between 1900 to 1500. How you determine what you cut it down to is gonna depend on two things. One, how quickly you want to achieve the fat loss. Obviously, the more calories you cut it by, the faster you're gonna lose that fat. But secondly, very important to note, is your tolerance to hunger. So let's say you want to lose fat faster, but you aren't very good with dealing with hunger. The faster you lose the fat, the more of a deficit you enter, the higher chance of hunger, and the sooner hunger is gonna start being experienced. So if you aren't very good at dealing with hunger, but you wanna lose fast, choose somewhere in the middle, maybe a 250 calorie deficit. If you don't mind losing it very fast and you're okay with going the more conservative route, and you're not tolerant to hunger, maybe go for the 100, roughly 100 calorie deficit. If you can tolerate hunger, no problem, and you want to lose the weight super fast, you can try and shoot for the 500 calorie deficit. Now, you need to continue tracking calories to make sure you're hitting those numbers every single day, and you need to keep tracking your body weight to make sure that it's moving you in the right direction. So, if you do not do those things going forward after this, after the first 7 days, you're gonna see very, very small, if any, results at all. And if you do see some results, they're gonna be very limited and they're gonna last a short period of time. These two fundamental habits are key. Do not give up on them. They might be wondering, so what do I eat? Well, let's just put it this way. Roughly 80% of your total calories for the day should come from micronutrient dense, nutritious whole foods. These are healthy foods, as people like to label them. The other 20%, you have the flexibility to make them whatever it is you want, so long as portions of whatever food you choose fit within those calorie targets you initially determined. If you want a video that goes even more in depth as to how to do this, how to achieve it, click right here and watch that one as well. Next, we're gonna talk about sleep. Look, you need 7 to 9 hours. That's non-negotiable. If you don't get 7 to 9 hours of sleep, you're getting 6 or less, 5, 4. Let me tell you this, you might see some results, but you're decreasing the chances of you sticking to your diet and your workout program severely. Secondly, the amount of harm you're doing to your body from a health standpoint is simply just not worth it. Those people who cut their sleep down that much actually usually don't know how much harm they're doing to their body, because if they did, trust me, you would get more sleep. You would prioritize it. How do I know? Well, because I was there, and when I found out the detriments of what I was doing, plus started experiencing them, it changed everything. Sleep is literally more important than diet and workouts combined. This is how important sleep is. If you want a video going into more depth as to how to increase sleep or get more sleep and get a better sleep schedule, click this video and it'll show you how. Next up is water intake. This one's very straightforward. Water, as I'm sure we know, I don't have to say it, okay? The benefits, endless. But water, you wanna aim to get a minimum of 2 liters right off the bat, okay? And you wanna get it up to roughly at least 3 liters in maybe 1 or 2 weeks' time. If you're somebody who doesn't drink water very often, you're probably dehydrated often, which you don't even realize, but you wanna start maybe tracking that water intake or grab a liter jug of water and just count how many liters you're getting throughout the day. Remember, it's not always more is better. You don't wanna get up to drinking 10 liters of water a day. You just wanna get up closer to that 3 liter mark, as most people will feel a lot better, be a lot more hydrated around that 3 liter mark. From there, you can take it up a little bit more if you feel more comfortable. Basically, all you gotta do is become more aware of your water intake, aim for 3 liters a day. You can start lower if you need to, work your way up, and then from there, take it as far as you want to where you're comfortable. Okay, let's talk about workouts now, weightlifting workouts. If you're not doing these, you must. Here, for this example, I'm gonna say that I recommend you work out 3 days a week, okay? This should be the minimum when it comes to weight training, but it can also be the maximum for a lot of people out there. 3 days a week, full body workouts where you're focusing on 1 to 2 major compound lifts per muscle group and focusing on getting stronger week to week within those lifts is all you need to see massive results in muscle gain, strength gain, and overall health. Of course, this helps with your fat loss, because as you start chipping away and losing weight, keeping or building muscle is gonna make you look 10 times better as the process occurs. For each one of the exercises that you do, you wanna have roughly 2 to 4 sets, and you want somewhere between 6 to 12 reps for the majority of it. Make sure that you're tracking your workouts, your weight, your reps, your sets, so that you can progress week to week. Without doing this, you're just guessing every time you go into the gym. Now keep in mind, you can increase frequency to 4, 5, or 6 days a week if you'd like, though it's not necessarily superior to 3-day full body workout splits. But if you're gonna do 4, 5, or 6 day splits, keep in mind that what you're hitting each day does change. So I'm gonna link my playlist that has everything you need to know about any and all of those workout splits right up here. Click on there, choose the workout split that you're gonna go with and follow that. But like I said, if you're more of a beginner, more somebody just getting into the weights, or somebody who really wants to maximize the time that they spend in the gym, 3 days a week, full body is a good place to start. All right, now last but not least, we're gonna talk cardio. Cardio is a tool and it should be viewed as such. It's not an end all be all. I must do cardio to lose fat. In fact, you don't have to do any cardio to lose fat, but I recommend doing cardio every day for the health benefits alone. On top of that, the tool of cardio is burning more calories. It's gonna keep your metabolism higher. It's gonna keep you it's gonna allow you to eat more food while losing fat. And of course, that's always a good thing. So cardio is gonna keep our metabolism up. What do I suggest? I suggest doing cardio at least every time you go to the gym for your weights, if you can do it every single day. But when you start, I would start with calorie targets. So let's say, for example, you're going in and whatever machine you can use that, or you can use a fitness tracker if you'd like. You're gonna aim for, let's say, 150 calories per cardio session. That way you actually have a target to hit and you can actually improve upon that target so you know you're progressing. So from there, you can take it up every week if you like, or every few weeks. As calories start coming down, you can also leverage increasing how many calories you're burning with the cardio. So let's say for the first few weeks, you start with 150 calories per session, then you go to 200 calories, then 250, 300, and so on. Also, here's a quick tip. What I recommend is you aim for a certain amount of calories and aim to do it within a certain amount of time. And your goal every single week is to beat that time it takes to achieve those calories. This gives you a twofold benefit of not only burning those calories and increasing your metabolism, but it's gonna actually improve your cardiovascular fitness, which comes with endless benefits on its own. Now, if you're wondering what type of cardio you should be doing for fat loss, you can check this video out where it goes into detail explaining them, but a quick hint, it doesn't matter. So follow this plan that I laid out for you, okay? These are all fundamentals. If you follow all the steps I just gave you right there, you will make more progress than you ever thought possible. You will make more progress than anybody on these other programs, so long as you stay true to it, stick to it consistently, accurately, keep yourself honest, and push through the times that you don't wanna go to the gym and that you don't wanna track your food and that you don't wanna eat healthy. Push through all that, and I promise you, you'll not only see amazing results, you will begin to create a lifestyle that you can sustain, that you can enjoy, that will keep you healthy and fit, confident, and more energy forever. Trust me, I do this for a living and I coach people with my coaching program on these things. So this is how myself and my clients see predictable results every single week. And again, if you're somebody who wants to take those results to the next level and cut through all of the trial and error that you might encounter along the way, again, apply for my one-on-one coaching. We'll jump on the phone and see if we're a good fit to help you get to those goals, okay? I look forward to it. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you hit the like button, comment below, whatever else you'd like to see when it comes to fat loss. And don't forget to share and subscribe because I'm dropping videos every single week. So I'll see you in the next one. I'm out.